somewhere in there is it, okay, for my people, I can probably like, I'll pull up and stuff, and the youngest can come out here with like a good 4 or 5 friends. And now we're our senior level, is that we don't understand what education was. So a lot of them are going back home to the exact same person they were at the age of like 16 or 17 years old. So really, in my opinion, they were educated. You know what I mean? They went to school. So I think for your young women, you know what education is. So we have to make you those same ideals we had as a young person. So I think that's what it's good. And that question, earlier, just like these symptoms, like it's typically with like academic status in class and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. If there's a thing, do you think the law is probably just causing these symptoms? Like it's causing us to have greater unemployment rates and things like that.
Well, I think we have to examine the basis of predatory capitalism that basically runs our country. The economic crisis is a function of nothing more than greed. Basically, predatory capitalists tend to extract surplus value from every monetary instrument that existed. Capitalism breeds these kinds of differences. I mean, there's racism, certainly, there's sexism, there's classism, but also you have an economic system that is designed to extract surplus value from people. And I think that in the very long run, we have to examine that. Now, please don't ask me how we get from where we are to where we ought to be in terms of the economic system that's more just. I mean, I think that that's the issue that many progressive economists grapple with. But I think that the disappointment that I've had in the past several months, and don't get me wrong, I've been excited not only about Biden's election inauguration, but also about the speed with which he's been able to put through both the stimulus package and bailout. He moved very, very quickly. You can go back, Eisenhower moved it. So we haven't had a president who's moved this quickly. Yet the kind of solutions we've seen are traditional Keynesian solutions. They're just not that different from what you might have done in 1964, 1984, and 1958. So that's the point. In addition, the people who created the mess have now been hired to clean it up. And that's just not right. You know, so that there's some disappointment. So that suggests a resistance to looking at different kinds of economic systems. Paul is writing, I think, brilliantly about asking, and Bob Cutter, asking for more imagination in the way we approach these economic solutions. I think that that's where, you know, where we need to be. I would have loved for President Obama to have done what Bill Clinton did, which was convene an economic summit before he went into office, so that you could have economists kind of back ideas and come in with something other than basic Keynesianism. Because a recovery that focuses on infrastructure is going to focus on jobs for unionized males. There's a subtext, unionized males basically white males. Does not mean females at all. And so there are some real issues there in terms of when we know that women in the African American community essentially had, you know, a significant number of households. So I don't think we've spent enough time really talking about how we move from predatory capitalism to something that generates more equal results. Thank you all very much.